I went to my mailbox yesterday and found on the ground a letter addressed to me that had been ripped in half. It was supposedly sent by Laura Bush, but I suspect it was actually sent by Republican fundraisers, and I get a million of them. I literally get dozens of them, one after another, asking for money. And I decided I would not give them any more money. I would use my efforts to support America through research on the internet. But the point is that somebody tore that letter in half, and I imagine that they were trying to express their disapproval of George Bush. I believe there is an orchestrated campaign to smear conservatives, even though conservatives are very hard to find nowadays. Very hard to find. An orchestrated campaign to smear conservatives. We know about Bill Ayers. We've heard his name repeatedly, but there are other Weather Underground members, and some of them are public, politically active, and have meetings with people of similar mind, and they talk about Barack Obama. In fact, I'm waiting for one of them to sue me for stealing their photographs and their words. But I don't consider it theft because I consider myself at war, and this is espionage. In war, there is no such thing as stealing. You can't steal anything from the enemy. And they consider us the enemy, and they are free to do anything they please to thwart their enemies. They can tell lies. They can infiltrate. They can use propaganda, and they do. I think the surprises make the electorate distrust elected officials and their ability to appoint people who are to be looking out for the public's interests, she says. This is an understatement. People not only don't trust the government, they are getting angry at the reckless policies that threaten national bankruptcy and may consign generations of Americans to living under socialism. I've got good news and I've got bad news. The bad news is that the United States is in big trouble. The good news is a few people are starting to see reality. I'm going to quote briefly from an article by Jeff Kincaid and provide a link to it in the description. In the middle of the article it says, "Now free to speak her mind, Alaska governor and former GOP vice presidential candidate Sarah Palin has weighed in, telling the Weekly Standard that she is getting tired of Paulson's changes to the bailout plan, and we're focusing here on Henry Paulson, Secretary of the Treasury. I think the surprises make the electorate distrust elected officials and their ability to appoint people who are to be looking out for the public's interest," she says. This is an understatement. People not only don't trust the government, they are getting angry at the reckless policies that threaten national bankruptcy and may consign generations of Americans to living under socialism.
Our conversation is with Mr. Yuri Alexandrovich Bezmianov. Mr. Bezmianov was born in 1939 in a suburb of Moscow. He was the son of a high-ranking Soviet Army officer. He was educated in the elite schools inside the Soviet Union and became an expert in Indian culture and Indian languages. The Soviets use the phrase ideological subversion. What do they mean by it?
Ideological subversion is the process which is legitimate, overt, and open. You can see it with your own eyes. But in reality, the main emphasis of the KGB is not in the area of its intelligence at all. According to my opinion, and opinion of many detectives of my caliber, only about 15% of time, money, and manpower is spent on espionage as such. The other 85% is a slow process which we call either ideological subversion or active measures, активные мероприятия in the language of the KGB, or psychological warfare. What it basically means is to change the perception of reality of every American to such an extent that despite of the abundance of information, no one is able to come to sensible conclusions in the interests of defending themselves, their families, their community, and their country. What it basically means is to change the perception of reality of every American to such an extent that despite of the abundance of information, no one is able to come to sensible conclusions. No one is able to come to sensible conclusions in the interests of defending themselves, their families, their community, and their country. No one is able to come to sensible conclusions.